We figured out what stars are by taking a look at the HR diagram and getting a better idea of each of the types of stars. Now we're going to look at planets. So there are over 4,000 planets that have been discovered out in the world, not including the 8 that orbit our sun. And there are 4 main types that these planets fall into. However, it bears mentioning that there are probably over 100 billion planets in our Milky Way galaxy alone, and our ways of figuring out exoplanets make it more likely for us to find certain exoplanets than others. So we have a lot to figure out here still, and perhaps you should check in again in 15 years to see where the state of the art is. But for the moment, there are 4 basic planet types. So let's jump into it. Here are the 4 planet types. You see an image. One's labeled a gas giant, then Neptune-like, then super Earth, then terrestrial. So pretty simple. Before we go into these 4 in a little more depth, let's try to figure out what exactly are planets. There are a lot of things in space that are made up of the things that planets are made up of. So what makes something a planet and not an asteroid or a comet or a molecular cloud or a brown dwarf? Planets are spherical objects, and they're orbiting stars in an orbit of their own. Anything that fills those 3 criteria will be considered a planet. So if you're not spherical, if you're more cloud-like, you're not going to be a planet, even if you're orbiting a star in an orbit of your own. If you are spherical and you're not orbiting a star, you're just shooting through space, you're not going to be a planet. And if you're spherical and you're orbiting a star, but there are other things in your orbit, such as an asteroid in the asteroid belt or Pluto in the Kuiper belt, then you're not big enough to have gravitationally vacuumed all of the material in your orbit to you, so that makes you not a planet. Now that we have what a planet is, and we can look at any object and say whether or not that's a planet, let's get a better idea of these 4 types of planets. Planets differ in 3 main ways. 1 in size, 2 in composition, what it's made out of, and 3 in its orbital distance. When we look at our solar system, we see 4 rocky planets, then an asteroid belt, and then 4 gassy planets. And we tend to think of them, and we traditionally call them, the rocky planets and the gas giant planets. However, when we look at the cosmos, it's clear that there are gas giants of different sorts, and that's reflected in our solar system as well, when you see that Jupiter and Saturn are a lot bigger than Neptune and Uranus. Let's start from the gas giant. A gas giant is like Jupiter. It's mostly made out of gas, mostly, like stars, made out of hydrogen and helium gas, only unlike stars, there's no nuclear fusion happening in Jupiter. And also in Jupiter, there's actually a rocky center. You can think of Jupiter as a very small rocky planet with a very big gaseous atmosphere. Moving a little lower than Jupiter, we move to Neptune-like planets. Now, Neptune-like planets are smaller than Jupiter. They're denser than Jupiter, but they're not rocky yet. They're still made out of a lot of gas. They could be made out of a lot of ice as well. Those planets are called Neptune-like planets, the gas giants are called gas giants, and you could also have mini Neptunes for Neptune-like planets that are in between the size of Earth and Neptune. But as far as I'm aware, we've never discovered a gas planet smaller than Earth. Second to last, there are super-Earths. Super-Earths are like Earth in that they're rocky planets, but they're much bigger than Earth, or at least they're bigger than Earth. They could be much bigger than Earth. And these are called super-Earths. And any rocky planet like a super-Earth, but that is smaller than an Earth, is called a terrestrial planet. And that's basically it. Those are the 4 types of planets. And for the time being, that's how we categorize them when we look at all the planets in the universe. At this point, our story is going to get a lot more specific. Right now, I didn't even look at what Earth in particular looks like, even though that's our planet, and it's a lot different than just the vague description of rocky planet. Now that we've hit planets and we're going to move to the level below planets, we're now going to take a look at life forms. And there's only one planet that we can meaningfully do that on for now. So our categories are going to be limited by the life forms that we find on Earth. Until next time, when we tackle life forms.